Hi guys and welcome to my channel, or welcome back if you've been here before. My name is Leslie and I make videos all about luxury, shopping, sometimes Korea, so if that sounds like a thing, definitely consider subscribing. And meanwhile you're down there, also hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on any of my future videos. I upload twice a week, usually on Tuesdays and Fridays, although I'm currently thinking about switching that up and going for Thursdays instead of Fridays. So I'll leave a survey on the screen right here, or just let me know in the comments which day you would prefer. I think I'll stick to Tuesday, but yeah, let me know if you prefer Thursdays or Fridays for my second video. But either way, I would love to have you back for two videos a week all about luxury and shopping. So a few weeks ago, I filmed my luxury SLG collection video. I'll leave a link to that one in the description box in case you haven't seen that one yet. But yeah, for today's video I thought I'd zoom in on one item that I did get quite a few questions on over on my Instagram, which by the way, feel free to follow me over there. It's Leslie Adina, all spelled together. But yeah, the item in question is the Hermès Bastia coin purse. As you can see, I have two of those, and in today's video I'll give you my review of the Bastia. We'll go over the measurements and other details, price tag and all that. I'll show you what actually fits inside the Bastia and what doesn't fit inside. We'll do a little comparison to the Hermès Calvi, which is like the bigger sister of the Bastia, if you will. And towards the end of the video, I'll share with you my opinion when it comes to the Bastia and if I think it's actually worth it. So as you would have seen in my SLG collection video, I actually have two Bastias. Both are in Epsom leather, which is like the grainy and pretty sturdy and scratch resistant leather. The color of this pink fuchsia one is called Magnolia and the blue one is called Bleu Royal. And with my Bastias, the inside has the exact same color as the outside, but there's also the Bastia Verso, which has a different color interior. I'll insert a picture of what that looks like on the screen. But yeah, mine have the exact same color on the inside as they have on the outside. The Bastia is actually produced in a number of different leather types. Mine, as I said, are both in Epsom, which is a very sturdy and scratch resistant one. And price wise, the Bastia comes in a different price tag depending on the leather you're going for. The Epsom ones are actually the cheapest ones at 230 USD or like 180 euros. I'll put it on the screen. But yeah, the Bastias range in price depending on which leather you're going for. For instance, the Bastia also comes in a goat skin that's a little softer and a lot more shiny from what I've heard. I don't own one myself, and it also comes in ever color, which is kind of similar to Epsom but a little less grainy and a little softer and silkier to the touch. The layout of the Bastia is actually pretty straightforward. You have this folding mechanism. It closes with a snap button closure, which is in silver hardware. And interestingly enough, the Bastia only comes with silver, or like as Hermès calls it, palladium hardware. No gold hardware, no rose gold. And down here, this is the actual pocket where you would put your stuff inside. And this little like tiny flap or lip right here seems to be pretty useless, but apparently it's kind of helpful when you put coins inside your Bastia, which I'll get to in a second and we'll try that out together. But yeah, that's about it. In terms of the measurements, we're talking about 3.3 inches in length and 3.1 in height. So almost a perfect square. And by the way, I'll put the measurements in inches and also in centimeters on the screen for your reference. And yeah, with that out of the way, I think we'll go into the what fits inside close-up portion of the video. So since 2020 is the year of the hand sanitizer and washing your hands while silently singing happy birthday twice, you'll have to excuse my dry hands. But yeah, as you can see, I've prepared some items to put inside the Bastia so you get an idea of what actually fits inside and how you'd be able to use the coin purse. Talking about coins, let's start with those, shall we? So as you can see, obviously you'll be able to put quite a few more inside the Bastia as I have right here, but yeah, to give you an idea, you'll have plenty of room inside the Bastia. And I mentioned this little flap or like lip right here, and this is actually how it's supposed to be used. So you just shake the Bastia a little and you'll end up with your coins right here, and that way you don't have to like pour all the coins inside your hand to pick which ones you're actually looking for. So yeah, that's kind of neat, and that way you don't get your hands too dirty. As for bills, I have a $1 bill and a 10 euro bill here to show you, yeah, to give you an idea of how you'll be able to fit them inside. Obviously the dollar bill is a lot longer, and both bills won't end up fitting inside just as it, but you can obviously fold it either once or definitely twice. It should fit in here. Yeah, kind of snug, but of course it obviously fits. And the euro bill, as it's a lot shorter, it will definitely fit inside the Bastia with a one fold. So there we go. And again, you can put additional coins in there or a lot more cash. But yeah, just to give you an idea, like size wise, bills will definitely fit inside, but obviously you'll have to fold them once. So next off, credit cards. I have this one right here. It took me a while to find one that doesn't have like any personal information on it, but yeah, that's the usual size of a credit card or your ID and stuff like that. And as you'll be able to see, it does fit, but it doesn't close. So yeah, that's definitely something to take into consideration. If you need something to put your like cards inside, the Bastia is not an option because the cards are way too long and they won't end up fitting like that either because, yeah, again, they are too long for the Bastia. If you're looking for something to actually fit your cards inside, you can go for the Hermes Calvi, which is, as I said, like the bigger sister of the Bastia. A lovely lady on Instagram was nice enough to provide me with a clip of her unboxing and showing a close-up of the Calvi, so I'll insert that on the screen right here. But yeah, as you can see, the Calvi is a lot more rectangular, obviously to accommodate for like regular sized and plastic cards, and you can put cards on either side of the flap. So yeah, if you're on the lookout for an SLG that allows you to carry around cards, honestly, I'd rather go for the Louis Vuitton Pochette Clé that I showed in a few of my other videos, just because it's a lot more affordable and versatile, plus it has a zipper. But if you're like dead set on getting something from Hermes, definitely look into the Calvi card holder. In case you're not fond of putting cash inside the Bastia, I have a few more options I quickly wanted to go through. First off, something I see a lot of people do is use the Bastia to hold their headphones. If you have ones with a cord, obviously they will end up fitting perfectly fine and yeah, zero problems, no bulging or anything like that. One thing I have never tried out is putting AirPods inside the Bastia. These, for reference, are the older style AirPods. It does fit. Maybe I should angle it the other way. Yeah, it does fit, but as you can see, there's a lot of bulging and it's definitely pushing it in terms of what I'd be comfortable putting inside the Bastia. But if you're set on keeping your AirPods in a specific pouch, the Bastia actually holds the AirPods, which I'm kind of surprised by. And lastly, you can use the Bastia as a small catch-all for like everyday items that would usually like just float around in your handbag. Bobby pins, for instance, band-aids, like medication and stuff, maybe a hair tie. I have this Invisibubble. Yeah, so that's definitely an option to like hold all your miscellaneous stuff that usually ends up floating around on the bottom of your handbag. So now would be the portion of the video where I talk through the wear and tear of the Bastias, especially the blue one, because I've had that one for almost 2 years now. Yeah, here's the thing. I think they actually have never left my apartment, which is kind of embarrassing, but you live and you learn, I guess. And the first time my Bastia touched coin or cash in general was a few minutes ago when I filmed the close-up videos. So yeah, I haven't really been using them apart from like Instagram flat lay pictures, which they do look very pretty on, I have to admit that. And that leads me to the conclusion and my opinion on whether the Bastia is actually worth it. And I do admit I am a bit torn on that one. On the one hand, I really love the simplicity and the idea of the Bastia and obviously the colors. I mean, the way Hermes is able to like capture these super vibrant colors is absolutely beautiful. But on the other hand, if you're anything like me and you carry around a regular sized wallet with you on a day-to-day basis, you might find the Bastia coin purse, at least for carrying cash, a little bit redundant, because usually wallets have a dedicated space for like your coins and change. But if you're a card holder kind of girl and you just need one tiny little additional pouch to keep like your spare change and stuff like that, I think the Bastia is a great way to go. Since most card holders don't have a zip or anything like that, you can't carry around cash in those. So that's where the Bastia could come in. So my recommendation would be just to assess your needs and preferences. If you have to think long and hard about what you'd actually be able to use the Bastia for, maybe reevaluate your wish or desire to get yourself a Bastia and maybe just put the $200 that you'd be spending on the Bastia towards a bigger purchase such as a handbag or something like that. And yeah, with that being said, thanks so much for watching. I hope I was able to help some of you out if you're currently thinking about adding a Bastia to your collection. I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. That would help out my channel tremendously. And also hit the subscribe button if you haven't done that already. And until next time, bye.